Hello students, once again very good morning to you all. This is the second video on how to prepare for preparatory test 1 on CPS. In the first video we discussed how to answer these 1 to 7 questions with a neat diagram. Explain the basic structure of a computer. What is structure of computer? Draw the diagram, label the diagram, explain all the units. That gives you good marks. And list the input devices, list the output devices, and explain few points about each device in less time with high speed. That gives you out of 4 marks. And what is scanf? Explain for formatted input and write the syntax and give examples. What is printf? And write syntax and give examples for formatted output available in studio.h. Minimum 2 pages so that you can get good marks. And we read length and breadth and we calculate the area. And we calculate the perimeter. Oh, here only I did mistake. Length into breadth I have written, here L plus B I have written. Sorry. It should be length plus breadth. Okay. I did mistake while giving questions itself. Sorry for that. Okay. Then explain different types of computer. Computers are classified based on principle of working, analog, digital and hybrid, based on size and capacity. Computers for individual users, desktop, workstation, laptop and tablet, smartphone. Computers for multiple users, mini, mainframe and supercomputer. What are C tokens? Smallest components of C program which cannot be divided further. Without C tokens we cannot write C program. That's an important topic. We need to know about all those. And list out the token, keywords, identifier, constant, strings, operators and special symbols, and you need to explain and structure of C program, the rules whichever we follow to write program. C program is called structure of C program, or the format followed by the programmer, and we studied. Today I explain slowly about the 8th question. Explain if and if else and nested if and else if ladder. Oh, I did mistake here. Okay. And cascaded if with examples. Okay, how to answer this question in exam? That when I explain, first I have to explain the simple if. What the simple if will do? It will check the given condition for true or false. If it is true, then only it follows the instructions from the true block. This is what we call true block of statements. This is one way decision making statement. Otherwise, if the condition is true, then only machine follows these instructions. Otherwise, no. To execute or skip, this is what we called what? One way, no choice at all. We have only one choice, one way decision making statement. If the condition is true, then only it works, otherwise no. Like that you have to explain. What is simple if? You write few points, write the syntax and draw the flowchart of it, give one minimum one programming example. If you do so, you get good marks. Similarly, if else. If else is two-way decision making statement. That means what is the syntax? Can you tell me? Syntax is like that. If is must. If it is true, true block works. Otherwise, else is must. And in the else block, false block of statements will be there. A machine follows any one of the block. If the condition is true, then machine follows true block of statements. If the condition is false, false block of statements. Any one of the block works. That's what is called as two-way. Explain, write the syntax, draw the flowchart, and give one programming example so that you can get good marks. Okay. And next one is nested if. Nested if means what? In the if only. This one is the condition one. And this is the condition 2, and if the condition 1 and condition 2 are true, then statement 1 works. Condition 1 is true but second one is false, then statement 2 works. If the first one false, then one more condition will be checked. Sorry, if the third one false, I go for directly statement 3. Followed by the remaining statements, that is what statement X. We have three choices here, 1, 2, 3. If both are true, one works, statement X. First is true, second is false, second works, statement X. First one only false. Statement 3 works. Statement X. We have 3 choices. Any one of them works. Nested if. You can use in else also one more if else. In this if, one more if. N number of times you can use within N. One another. Depending on problem. Like this, explain, write syntax, draw flowchart and give example. You get good marks. And else if ladder. If we give, then condition 1. If it is true, statement 1 works. And if it is false, then only the second condition will be checked by machine. That is for true or false. If it is true, second works. If it is false, then the third one will be checked. And if it is true, then the statement 3 works. And else if. And you can continue as many as you wish. Or you go for default statement and statement X. That means machine will check the condition. If it is true, 1 works. Directly remaining statement X. If it is false, then only second one will be checked. If it is false, if it is true, 2 works followed by statement X. Statement X not related to else if ladder. It is called else if ladder because if else is used only in the else part of previous if else. If else is used only in the else part of the previous if else. That's what is called as else if ladder or cascaded if because we find one pattern. Usually we check if the first one is true, first one works. That's all. Exit. Usually we check the value in order depending on problem. Give example, you get good marks. Next one is switch. Switch is really very important. Most of the time in VTU main examination that question was asked. What is switch? Switch helps us to provide menu options. Oh, menu. User can choose any one of the options from that displayed menu. 1 is for so and so, 2 is for so and so, 3 is for so and so, 4 is for exit. Enter your choice. Okay, if I choose the 1, that works accordingly. If I choose 2, that works accordingly. 3 or 4. How to develop such softwares or apps? We use switch. To the body of switch, we pass one value. Don't use semicolon. The value, whichever we pass, that might be the value 1. If so, block 1 works. Statement block 1 works. And break takes place. If the passed value is not the first one, then the value 2 will be compared. Colon is must. And statement block 2 works and the break is optional. You may use or you may not, but best practice to use it. If you won't use break, execution moves to next block. That's why use the block. And then case value 3, and if it matches with the third one, then block 3 works and exit takes place. Like that, you can check many. If there is no match found, then the default statements are going to work. And at the end, you may write or you may not the break, and the break completes, followed by the sequential execution statements. Every time, those are going to work. Write the syntax like this, you get good marks. Then draw the flowchart of it as I taught in class. And don't forget to give an example, right? And you can draw the limitations, some important points about the switch. You can pass only integer value or the character constant for comparison. But inside the block, inside the body of switch, you can use any value. That is what important points you can write. And default is also optional. You may write anywhere. It works only if there is no match found. Write some important points like this so that you can get good marks in examination. This is what all about this question. Explain. Okay, I hope you understood. Break and continue. Don't very interesting question. Break and break we use in switch also. Break we use in switch to exit of the block body of a switch. We use in while to exit from that. We use in do while. We use in for based on condition. That means this is what the while you can say. Here we have one condition. And here flower bracket and closing bracket, and here we have statements, and here we have if condition. Whenever the condition becomes true, then we exit from the while, otherwise the loop completes successfully. Similarly, continue means what? The loop completes successfully, but whenever this condition will be true, these below statements are not going to work. Like that, explain, write the syntax, give example so that you can good marks in examination. What is switch? Just only explain. Explain different types of loops. Oh, very simple question. And you need to explain while and write the syntax. What is while? You need to explain and write the syntax. While into bracket condition. If the condition is true, then the execution of the while starts. In the while we have n number of instructions, all the instructions will be executed if the condition is true. Whenever it becomes false, stops. This is what all about while. Do while means what? Here we write do, and at the end we write the while, and the semicolon is must. Okay, before checking condition, at least once works compulsory. That is what the difference between while and do while. While is entry control, do while is exit control. At least once this works must. If the condition is true, it repeats, otherwise no. And for is having two parts. First part is for initialization. Assign the initial value I equals 0, I equals to 1, I equals whatever you want. In the second, after semicolon, we give one condition for repetitive process. Last one is for the increment of counter, or you can decrement the counter depending on the problem to be solved. No semicolon for it. Body starts and body completes, and give examples. You get good marks. Thank you. This is what all about how to answer this question. Thank you. Next, write a C program to check entry number is palindrome or not. I explain you the core code. I don't have time. I read one number, ampersand num. I store in temporary variable number. Then while number is not equals to 0. Yeah, number is not equals to 0. Number is not equals to 0. Then extract the last digit from it. How to extract the last digit from it? How to extract the last digit? Can you answer my question? Reminder equals to num mod 10. It extracts the last digit. Store in the reverse variable. First time reverse is 0. 0 into 10 will become 0. 0 plus the reminder. Last digit we stored in the reverse. Then reduce one digit from the number. For that purpose, number equals to number upon 10. Like this, we reverse the number and we print the reverse number and we compare whether the reverse number matches with the temporary. Temporary is having the original number. If both are same, then that is palindrome, otherwise not palindrome. Okay. Like that, write the program correctly so that you can get good marks. And to find largest of three numbers, choice is yours. You can use the nested if or else if ladder. Anyone you can use. You can use largest of three numbers. Choice is yours. A simple way I tell you, if A is greater than B and A is greater than C, then print A. Otherwise, else if B must be greater than A, and logical line B must be greater than C, then print B. Otherwise, print C. It is easiest method. One more is if A greater than B, then if A greater than C, then A will be greater. Okay, else C will be greater. A is greater than B, A is greater than C, A is greater. U is greater than B, A is not greater than C, C will be greater. U is greater than B, no, no means B is greater. Either B is greater than C, yeah, that means you have to print the B. A is greater than B, no, B is greater than C, no, no means C will be greater. This is what we call nested if, this is what we call else if ladder. Solve in your own way. You can solve it by using a conditional operator also. Answer equals to A is greater than B. If so, A will be returned back, otherwise B will be returned back. We have calculated the largest of first two numbers. Then answer is having the largest of first two numbers. Next, what I do? This answer I compare with third number. Whether it is more than 3, then answer I return. Otherwise, I return C. Now, answering the largest of three numbers, you can solve by using any of them. Okay, thank you. Okay, I explained the remaining questions. I have less time. Okay, and area and circumference of circle. Read the radius. A equals to pi r square. Circumference equals to 2 pi r. Simple interest. Float PTR. SI equals to PTR of 100. Three sides ABC to write. S equals to A plus B plus C upon 2. Area equals to square root of S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Leap year. And in my notes, everything is there. Please check. Sorry. Thank you. Have a nice day. All the best.